Nobody changes the world,
standing in the crowd.
Nobody's voice is ever heard
until they open their mouth.
Won't let a loud go quiet, won't let the saints go silent. Let's turn it up, tell the world what we're about.
Identity family, thanks for joining us tonight. Thank you for inviting us into your home. It's been a crazy last half hour to an hour. We had issues with OBS. My poor kids are probably getting ready to cry because I've been yelling, but I've almost lost it a few times with all this technology. Technology is awesome because it's allowing us to come into your home. It's allowing us to be a part of your family and you be a part of ours. So it also has hangups. We're kind of off the cuff tonight. One thing that I really miss about Identity is the worship with all of the students. I truly miss seeing all of the faces and having all of the different individuals worship. Over the last few weeks, we've had the honor and the privilege of having Imagio, who's my son, Neva, who's my daughter, and Olivia, who's my niece, lead worship. You've seen those three over the last couple of weeks, but I wanted to do something different this week, so we're actually going to have, we had one of our other worship leaders, Cadence Jordan lead. That's on mine. My phone's ringing. Sorry, yeah. We have Cadence Jordan leading us, but before we get to that, let us go ahead and pray real quick. Dear Heavenly Father, we just come to you tonight. God, and I just ask that you would calm the spirits. Calm our souls, calm our minds, Lord God. Calm my mind, my spirit, my soul, my heart. Lord God, help me to understand that if all of this doesn't go perfect, your word will not return void. God, and that's what this is about. This is about reaching students where they are. God, helping them navigate through this time in which we live. So God, I ask that I would decrease, that you may increase. God, I ask that every word that I speak would penetrate the very heart and souls of every student that is watching, and every parent, and every aunt, uncle, and whoever's watching. I just ask that you would be with each and every one of us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hey, please join us in worship.
We just want to know you. We just want to know you. So come. all my doubts will go. You're pulling me close until my heart to rest. You know what is best, yes. You're not done yet. You're right, beautiful for me. You're right, beautiful for me.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You've been so, so kind to me. And oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. When I was your foe, still your love fought for me. And you have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind to me. And all the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God always chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. And I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it. Shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me.
Welcome. Thank you for joining us. Are there any TikTokers out there? If so, comment, give us a thumbs up, a heart sign. Just put those in the comments because we want to see where our TikTokers are.
So our Identity Ladies have created a TikTok. We didn't create the TikTok challenge, but we joined the TikTok challenge and we're challenging the boys to see if they could make one that's funnier than ours. Here's our video.
Hey, Identity Girls, have you ever seen an Identity Boy lift more than 4 chairs?
No, but have you ever showered with your socks on?
Yes, but did you ever get your crackers out of the dishwasher?
Oh my gosh, yes! Do you like chicken?
No, but did you know Jesus turned water into wine?
No. But have you ever eaten spaghetti with your toes?
Yes. Do you drink your coffee with hot sauce?
Yes, but have you ever hit a dead body?
Yeah. Isn't it true that you eat mustard with your ice cream?
Ew, no. Do pineapples go on pizza?
No. And do you like being in quarantine?
No, but have you ever let your mom cut your hair?
No. Do you pick your nose?
Oh, yes.
All right. Well, Welcome back, Identity. Let me hit mute over here so I don't get that echo. Okay, so that was the TikTok challenge. Fellas, I don't know, first of all, I'm a little, I don't know about you, but I don't know if you caught this, but first of all, not only did they challenge us to a TikTok, did you hear what Neva said? She said the ladies came up with, and then she called us boys. First of all, she called the females ladies, which they are, and then she called us, the fellas, boys. So my men, my fellas, my identity fellas, we got to step up big time. So I'm going to be contacting you fellas to let you know how to do this challenge. We've got to come up with a better challenge, or we got to beat them, and we got to turn it on. I've got Imagio here with me tonight. We're going to talk a little bit about just this whole COVID-19 shelter in place. I know some of it is we're coming, it sounds like, or it looks like, hopefully there's some states and on a national level, they're talking about maybe coming out of this to see what, you know, the next steps are. Maji, and talk about what COVID's looked like for you.
So like for me, it's really been a good time to appreciate, you know, like look back in how much I did have and how much I still have at this during this whole quarantine thing. You know, I have my family here to back me up, and like I have companionship. Of course, we miss things like our friends, but it reminded me like how lucky we are, because I could always just FaceTime them. I know most of you have been FaceTiming your friends, but yeah. So it's just been really enlightening to know that we're so fortunate to like have all this stuff, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Well, good deal. Well, so again, man, you know, it sounds like hopefully we're you know, there's always conflicting reports. You know, you hear some that talk about, hey, the last couple of weeks were supposed to be the worst 2 weeks, and then it feels like we're getting over that. Some are saying, no, it's going to be not for a long time. Hey, what we can do as Christians is we can constantly pray, and that shouldn't be the last resort. That should be our first resort, where we think about what can we do. Obviously, we can get on our face and we can pray. Pray for the leadership of our country, that they make wise decisions, that they don't maybe jump the gun on releasing us back into the society, you know, into just, you know, the normal daily lives. Pray for the doctors and the nurses and the front, you know, all the people on the front line, and, you know, grocery workers. It seems like they're probably getting, you know, pray for those who might be getting laid off and losing their jobs. You know, you students might not realize it. You know, for you, it's kind of a bummer because, you know, you messed out on some of the stuff towards the end of the year. You've messed out on some things at school, like prom and spring sports and that kind of stuff. But there are men and women who are losing their jobs and are being laid off and having to take furloughs. And it's going to impact the economic system in a few months. We're really going to feel it. So let's make sure we keep those people in prayer too. Just everybody. Keep everybody as a nation and as the world. This is a world pandemic that is going on. So, yeah. With that, Maj, thanks for joining me. I'm going to go ahead and get into tonight's message. So before I get into the message, man, I just want to give a shout out. I'm kind of looking back here because I have we have Facebook on the TV there. I see it looks like Jenna. Is that Jenna Godinez joined just now. Hey, what's up, girl? I see Vera. I'm not sure if Drea's on. They have already scrolled up or scrolled down. But Drea, if you're on, I know I've missed you the last couple of weeks. Hey, girl, what's up? Sure do miss you. We'll see you shortly, hopefully. All of those of you who have joined us, thank you. Again, my cousins in Texas, my family in Texas, they're joining. My cousin, who's actually a preacher, Marcos, in Texas, at the Gathering Church, he joined us live. So just want to thank you guys all for joining us. Hey, do me a favor, drop a comment. Let us know that you're watching us. Let us know if Identity Livestream has been a blessing to you. And do me another favor, like and share. Make sure you like and share our Facebook page. Make sure you like and share our videos. And also do me a favor, go to our YouTube channel and subscribe to that. And that way we can get what God is doing in Identity and in Pueblo out to the city of Pueblo, out to the state of Colorado. And hopefully one day we'll be nationally, not because we want to be, you know, national for just to be national. We want to spread the word of God. We want to get it out there to everybody. All right. All right, hey, tonight I'm going to kick off a series called Price Tags. We just came out of our series called Storms, and tonight we're going to be talking about price tags. I don't know about you, but I believe that everything has a price. It might not have a dollar value on it, but you give up something in exchange for something else. And I hope by the end of this series, we will learn how to count the cost. The title of tonight's message is The Cost of Giving Up, or The Cost of Quitting. How many of you look at a price tag when you go into the mall and before the lockdown or the shelter in place, when you went to the mall or you went to your favorite store or even went online, how many of you looked at the price tag before you decided if you really liked the shirt, the hoodie, the joggers, the sneakers? You look at the price tag before you decide if you really like it or not, right? Because I don't want to fall in love with something if I really don't want to purchase it for whatever price it is. You know, not too long ago, I was looking for a truck. I was in the market for a truck. I was actually in the market for a truck for a long time. It took me like 4 years to actually buy the truck because I was just, you know, I'd go in and out. But one of the things that would drive me crazy is when I was on the websites, I was looking, and a lot of the websites have the price. It's like internet price, $10,000, right? Internet price, $15,000. And then there was some websites that would say call for price. And I would just swipe. I mean, I don't even want to look at that. I don't even need to call you. If you can't post your price, I don't even want to deal with it, right? How many of you are like that? How many of you know the price you pay for a vehicle is just the beginning? You see, over the life of the car that you've been begging your parents for, ID students, over the life of that car, you're going to have what is called the total cost of ownership. What is the total cost of ownership, or the TCO? It includes the purchase price, so whatever that car price is on the window sticker, but it also includes things like gas, insurance, tires for that car. So there's more than just the price of the car. There's other costs that sometimes we forget about. Sometimes, you know, when you're buying a car, you're like, oh, it's $10,000 and the payment's $200. I can afford that. But then you forget about the insurance, and you forget about the gas, and you forget about the oil changes, and you forget about the tire rotations, and you forget about all of that stuff that it takes to keep that car running. Sometimes in life, we have to learn how to count the costs to do for something that we do, and sometimes for the things that we don't do. You see, it's easy sometimes to count the cost, right? You can take the price of a car and you can say, okay, let's just say, for example, the car has no miles on it. And in your mind, you think, if I drive this car for 200,000 miles, then you divide that 200,000 by 3,000, which is every 3,000 you get an oil change. And if an oil change is on average $20, then you multiply that. There's some math you can do to come up with the calculation of what it might cost you to own a car. But sometimes in life, it's not so easy to calculate the cost of doing or not doing something. So what is the cost of giving up? What is the cost of quitting? Does quitting or giving up cost anything? Galatians chapter 6, verse 9, the Bible says this: let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we don't give up. It sounds like the cost of giving up in Galatians chapter 6, verse 9 is if you give up, you won't reap the harvest. I want to talk to you tonight a little bit about a man named Job. For those of you who don't know Job, He in the Bible, the Old Testament, we find his story. And in chapter 1 and chapter 2 of Job, we learn that Job was, the Bible says, he was the greatest of all people in the East. He was wealthy. He was a man of swag. I mean, he had it, right? He had the latest and the greatest. The Bible says that he had 7 sons and 3 daughters. He owned 7,000 sheep and 3,000 camels, 500 oxen, and 500 donkeys. and he had a large number of servants. He went from having all of that in chapter 1 to losing all of it, chapter 2. You see, Job, chapter 2, he goes and he loses all this. He loses his sons and his daughters. He loses his oxen and his cattle. Things are going on. We talked about storms last year, and right now in chapter 1 and chapter 2, Job is walking through a storm in his life. He's walking through a time kind of like we are right now, a time of unfamiliar territory, a time of storms, a time of everything is going wrong in Job's life. And in chapter 2, verse 9-10, Job's wife says this. His wife said to him, "Are you still maintaining your integrity?" What does she mean by that? And all of this, what happens is Job's servants run in and they tell him, "Hey man, your donkeys and your camels, they got stolen." And then somebody else runs in and says, "Hey man, your kids were having a feast and the house collapsed in on them and it killed them all." And while Job's finding all of this out, he refuses to curse God. He refuses to throw up his arms like sometimes we do. Sometimes you and I do. We throw up our arms and we ask God, "Why me?" When everything seems to be going wrong in my life, when everything seems to be going the other way than I wanted it to go, I don't know about you, but I sometimes look up at God and I ask God, "Why me?" Well, Job refused to do that. And his wife said to him, "Are you still maintaining your integrity? Curse God and die." That's what she told him. She told him to curse God and die. Listen to his reply, verse 10. "You are talking like a foolish woman. Shall we accept good things from God and not trouble?" That's good. Listen to that again. He said, "Should we accept good from God and not trouble?" The Bible goes on to say, in all this, Job did not sin in what he said. All I would have to say to Job is, if I were Job, I would kind of be like, "Bye, Felicia," right? I mean, how many of you would have told his wife, "Bye"? You see, you got to be careful who you listen to when the going gets tough. You got to be careful to the voices and the advice that you take when the going gets tough. This might seem like a common theme because we talked about this in storms, but every story it seems that I read in the Bible has advice on listening to or being careful on who you listen to. Job chapter 3, verses 1 and 4. After this, Job opened his mouth and he cursed the day of his birth. He said, "May the day of my birth perish, and the night that..." Let's see here. Sorry, my notes. This thing just is tripping out on me. Again, technology. All right, we were at by Felicia. Okay, so Job 3, 1 and 4. After this, Job opened his mouth and cursed the day of his birth. He said, "May the day of my birth perish, and the night that said a boy is conceived, that day may it turn to darkness. May God above not care about it. May no light shine upon it." So Job finally gets to a point where he's like, "You know what? I'm not going to curse God, but I'm going to curse myself." How many times do we do that? How many times, like Job, when things seem to be going wrong, we begin to throw, not a pity party, but we begin to blame ourselves. We begin to curse ourselves. Like, why was I ever born? If nothing in my life is going to go right, why was I born? If this is why you designed me, God, why was I born? And that's what Job is doing. Job is saying, "Curse the day that I was born, but be careful, little mouth, what you say." Because the Bible teaches us that life and death are in the tongue. The Bible tells us that we have the ability and the power in our tongue to create life and to create death into situations. Job chapter 4 goes on to say in verses 3 through 6. So what's going on here is Job's friends, they hear about what's going on in his life. So three of his buddies decide to go over there and be with Job. They show up And for 7 days, they just sit there in silence. They don't say anything. They're just with him. They're just embracing him. They're letting him know that they're there for him without saying anything.
Amen.
Then after a while, Job begins to curse himself and begins to say these things. Listen to what his friends say. One of his friends stands up and says this: "Think how you have instructed many, how you have strengthened feeble hands. Your words have supported those who stumble. You have strengthened weak knees." This is squad goals. Surround yourself with people who will be tough when things get rough. You see, his friends for a minute, for a while, they let him feel what he needed to feel. They let him have his emotions because the man had just lost his sons and his daughters. The man had just lost his livelihood. He lost pretty much everything he owned. They didn't come in and tell him, "No, Job, you need to pick yourself up. Job, you need to stop moping around." No. They sat with him for 7 days. They were with him. But after a while, they finally said, "Hey, man, it's time to pick yourself up. It's time to dust yourself off. It's time to remember who you are."
Amen.
And in this moment, whatever you're going through, whatever's coming at you, whatever's coming your way, it's time for you to remember who you are. Amen. God didn't bring you this far to leave you right now. God, the Bible says what he has started, he will finish. He didn't bring you this far just to let COVID-19 destroy you. Goes on to say, "But now trouble comes to you," his friend tells him, "and you are discouraged? It strikes you and you are dismayed? Should not your pity be your confidence and your blameless ways your hope? Should not the way you have lived in the past be your hope that all things work together for good?" That's basically what his friend is saying. His friend is saying in verse 5, but now trouble comes to you and you are discouraged? It strikes you and you are dismayed? Should not your pity be your confidence and your blameless ways your hope? His friends were reminding him of who he was. His friends reminded him that he was better than that. I know we're living in difficult times. I know there's a high school senior who will never experience their senior prom. I know there's a high school junior who lost out on a season of spring sports. I know there's a sophomore that lettered their freshman year and was hoping to be a four-year letterman, and now that's in jeopardy because their spring sport was canceled. I know there's a high schooler or a middle schooler, and you feel disconnected and from what was once normal. I know there's some of us who've lost out on some things, and it kind of feels like something was taken from us. But just like Job, it feels like everything has been taken from you. But let me tell you this right here, right now. Now's not the time to quit. Now's not the time to throw in the towel. Now's not the time to give up or give in. Now's not the time to just quit. Now's the time to pick ourselves off, dust ourselves off, and continue to push forward so that we can reap the harvest in due time.
Amen. Good work.
There was a man by the name of Walt Disney. He was fired in 1990 from his job at the Kansas City Star Paper because he lacked imagination. He would go on to be fired and rejected 300 more times before he created Disney, Walt Disneyland, and Walt Disney World. Today, Walt Disney's net worth is $5 billion. Thomas Edison, man by the name of Thomas Edison, his teacher told him he was too stupid to learn anything. Those are the words of the teacher. Edison would, on his 10,000th try, invent the light bulb. When asked about failing 9,999 times, he answered, "I never failed. I just learned 9,999 ways not to make a light bulb." There's a man right now, a series that just came out about what I believe is the GOAT of basketball. And the man's name is Michael Jordan. called the greatest basketball player of all time, Jordan is credited with once saying that I have missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. He goes on to say, I failed over and over and over again in my life. And that is why I succeed. You see, the only time you'll succeed is by getting up and pushing on. You see, Job's story didn't end back in chapter 4. Job's story didn't end in chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's just the beginning of Job's story. Job 42, verse 10 and 17, the Bible says this. After Job had prayed for his friends, the Lord restored his fortune and gave him twice as much as he had before. The Lord blessed the latter part of Job's life more than the former part. He had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. And he also had 7 sons and 3 daughters. I don't know what kind of storm you're going through tonight. I don't know, other than this COVID-19, I don't know what is going on in your life. But I do know this, there is a cost of quitting. Had Job quit like his wife told him to, had Job given up and just quit on life, had Job cursed God and died like his wife said, he would have never reaped double that he had. That would have been his cost for quitting. My friend, tonight, there's somebody who's thinking about quitting. And you don't know the cost that it's going to, you don't know the price it's going to cost you if you do. So my challenge to you tonight is this. Don't quit. Count the costs. Don't give up. Don't quit. Don't give in. God is faithful and he will finish what he started in your life and in mine. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I just come before you tonight. God, I thank you for each and everybody who is listening and who listened, Father. God, I ask that you would penetrate the very heart and souls of every individual who tuned in tonight. God, I ask that you would be with them, that you would embrace them in your arms, that you would let them know that you have a plan and a purpose. Let them know that there is value and there is worth within inside of them. Let them know that there are great gifts inside of each and every one of them. God, and I just ask that they would use their gifts to give you honor and glory. God, I ask that you would pull us out of this pandemic, that we would come out stronger as a church, that the church would wake up and we would just come out stronger, we would come out more on fire, and we would come out ready to work. In Jesus' precious name, we give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. Amen and amen. Hey, thank you again for joining us. Love you guys. Make sure, again, you check us out on YouTube. Check out our Instagram page. Make sure you like and share. Also, make sure you check out Praise on Sunday. Love you guys. See you next week. You can just hit and go live. We got some technology we're trying to learn here. This is my team, my team, my wife, and I'm going to zoom in on you guys. We're all learning how to do all this stuff. Here we go. Boom, here's the identity tech team. All right.